Hello and welcome to One and All. My name is Lakshman Jolly and I'm an intern at Lexis & Co. I'm a third year law student at New Law College, Pune, and the topic for the day is Rashtriya Raksha University Bill 2020. Mr. Amit Shah, Minister of Home Affairs, introduced Rashtriya Raksha Bill University Bill 2020 in the Lok Sabha on March 23, 2020. The Rashtriya Raksha University is to establish, according to the bill. The bill essentially seeks to establish Rashtriya Raksha University in national importance by upgrading the pre-existing Raksha Shakti University, Gandhinagar. It further repeals the 2009 Act. Under the university, the bill establishes a number of authorities. These include, first, a governing body, which will set the university board policies, programs. Second, the executive council, which will be the primary executive body. Third, the academic council, which will be the university academic policies. The university principal goals are to provide dynamic and high-quality learning and research. Second, provide a working environment dedicated to the developing, policy, research, teaching, and training. Third, promote and provide public safety. The university responsibilities include, first, offering instruction on research in the policy sciences, such as coastal policy and cybersecurity. Second, founding and managing colleges. Third, prescribing courses, administering exams, and awarding degrees to the other distinctions. The governing body will be in charge of university administrative activities. It will be made up of 15 people. The members will have one vice chancellor appointed by the central government, one representative from the Ministry of Home Affairs nominated by the central government, not below the rank of joint secretary, one representative from state police universities by rotation, three experts in defense, policy, internal security, and related fields. Members that are nominated will serve for 3 years. The governing body primary responsibilities include, first, formulating university policies and programs. Second, advising on matters relating to the course duration, degree conferment, and admission standards. Third, specifying policies that relating to administration and working of the university and making related decisions. And fourth, drafting statutes that will specify the establishment, operation, and governance of the university. The university's first laws will need to be approved by the federal government. The university will keep a fund that will be used to cover its cost. Fund will receive the following amounts. First, contribution from the federal government or state governments. Second, grants, gifts and donations. Third, fee income. Fourth, amount received by any other source. The federal government must approve these funds before they can be invested. Any student or candidate whose name has been removed from the university rolls and who has been prevented from taking exams for more than 1 year may request a review of the decision by the governing body, and any dispute originating from the university disciplinary action against the student may be referred to an arbitration tribunal at the request of the student. Disputes originating from an employee's contract with the university may also be addressed at the arbitration tribunal. The university is also said to have linkage with various world-class universities which allow for students to exchange contemporary research, academic collaboration, course design, technical know-how, training and skill development. That was all. Thank you.